Hello everyone. So here in this problem we have to evaluate limit x tends to infinity hyperbolic sine inverse of x upon hyperbolic cos inverse of x. Now to find out the value of this limit, here first of all I will substitute the formula of hyperbolic sine inverse of x, and the formula is hyperbolic. Okay, so before that we will say this limit as L. So here I'll say let L is equal to limit x tends to infinity hyperbolic sine inverse of x upon hyperbolic cos inverse of x. Next I am substituting the formula for this. So we have the formula of hyperbolic sine inverse x in terms of logarithm, and why we are doing this is because most of the students don't know about the derivative of hyperbolic sine inverse of x and hyperbolic of cos inverse of x, and for that, to make it easier, we are substituting the formula of hyperbolic sine inverse of x. So here the formula is log of x plus square root of x square plus 1. Similarly, the formula of hyperbolic cos inverse of x is log of x plus square root of x square minus 1. So now we can check for infinity whether we are getting finite or infinite value. So if we'll see here, then by substituting x as infinity over here, we'll get infinity plus infinity, and log of infinity is infinity. That means you are getting infinity in the numerator. If you'll check here, you'll get infinity plus infinity, again infinity, and log of infinity is also infinity. It means here we are getting the value as infinity upon infinity, which is indeterminate form. And whenever we get indeterminate form, we apply the L'Hopital's rule by which we make the limit finite, or we find out the finite value of limit. So here I'll say by L'Hopital's rule, we'll get L as limit x tends to infinity. Now we'll find out the derivative of numerator and derivative of denominator. So first let's find out the derivative of numerator. So it is 1 upon x plus square root of x square plus 1 into derivative of x is 1 plus derivative of root of x square plus 1 is 2 times root of x square plus 1, and again derivative of x square, that is 2x. Similarly, the derivative of denominator is 1 upon x plus square root of x square minus 1. Next, derivative of x is 1 plus derivative of this is 2 upon root of x square minus 1, and the derivative of x square is 2x in the numerator. Now here we can cancel the 2 term. Next, by performing the cross multiplication, here we will get 1 into this, that is root of x square plus 1 plus x. And we can cancel that term with this term, x plus root of x square plus 1. Similarly, we can do it here. So let's simplify it. So therefore, we will get L equal to limit x tends to infinity. Now the term which is outside is x plus root of x square plus 1. In the bracket, by cross multiplication, we will get root of x square plus 1 plus x whole upon root of x square plus 1. Similarly, in the denominator, here also we'll get root of x square minus 1 plus x. So outside term as it is, that is x plus square root of x square minus 1. In the bracket we will get root of x square minus 1 plus x upon root of x square minus 1. Now these two terms are cancelled. Similarly, these two terms are cancelled. Now this term will go in the denominator and this term will come in the numerator. So therefore we will get L as limit x tends to infinity root of x square minus 1 upon root of x square plus 1. And now if we'll try to substitute the value of x as infinity, here we'll get infinity minus 1 infinity and infinity in the denominator. It means we are again getting indeterminate form. So it means we have to again apply the L'Hopital's rule. So by L'Hopital's rule, so here I'll say by L'Hopital's rule, we will find out the derivative of numerator in the numerator and the derivative of denominator in the denominator. So therefore, here we'll get L as limit x tends to infinity. Now the derivative of this term is 1 upon 2 root x square minus 1 into 2x whole upon, here the derivative is 1 upon 2 root x square plus 1 into 2x. Now this 2 and 2 is cancelled. Similarly, this x and x can be cancelled, but if you'll cancel this x and x, then you'll again land up on the same term and it will go, and if you'll check it again, then you'll again get the same term. It means you won't get the answer. So do not cancel it. So what we'll do here is, instead of cancelling it, we will take this term in the denominator and we'll bring it inside the square root. So here this term will become L equal to limit x tends to infinity. Now I'm taking this x in the denominator and inside root, so that will become 1 in the numerator, and in the denominator inside square root we already have x square minus 1. So when we'll take it in the denominator, that will go in the denominator and it will become x square, because we are taking it inside the square root. So when we'll take the square root, this x square will become x and it will go in the numerator and you can again get the original term. Similarly, for this denominator, we can get 1 upon square root of x square minus 1, x square plus 1 that we have in the denominator upon x square, because I am taking that x inside the square root. So whenever you take any term inside the square root, we have to square the term. So after that, we'll divide this x square and minus 1 with x square separately, and similarly over here. So now we'll get, therefore, L equal to limit x tends to infinity 1 upon square root of 1 minus 1 upon x square. So we got this term from here. X square upon x square is 1 minus 1 upon x square. Whole upon, here we'll get 1 plus 1 upon x square. So whole upon 1 upon square root of 1 plus 1 upon x square. And now if we'll try to substitute this x as infinity, then here we'll get L as 1 upon square root of 1 minus, now 1 upon infinity is 0, and similarly here we'll get 1 plus 1 upon infinity 0. Now why it is 0? Because as we say that, let's say we have some number, let's say 1, and we are dividing it with 0, then we get value as infinity. So if I'll take this infinity over here, then that 0 will go there. It means I can say that 1 upon infinity is equal to 0. So we are using this result everywhere, that is 1 upon infinity is 0. So here we are getting 1 upon infinity square, that is infinity. So 1 upon infinity is 0, and here also we are getting 1 upon infinity as 0. And now if we'll solve this, then we'll get value of L as 1. So the value of L is equal to 1. Thank you.